Hello everyone, welcome back to Adventures of Well on Me, and today we're going to be doing a bit of a bonus episode. In this episode we're going to be going through and we'll be checking out all the areas that we didn't visit throughout our story playthrough. I'll be trying to get the rest of the hearts and I'll be trying to collect all the Poes. Whether this takes one episode, two episodes, four, whatever it is, we'll be doing that. So I've got a Poe Souls guide up on my laptop, which I'll be referring to while I'm playing this episode. And there's also the map part that we didn't get to in the lead up to the boss, which I now know how to do. I actually checked that out. So I'll go do that first. I realised, out of my own stupidity, I didn't save before I went into fight Ganon. And because the game resets, when you finish the game, it doesn't save afterwards, which I'm used to in a lot of games. And I forgot about this fact. We didn't actually have, it didn't take us back to the area that we're up to, so I actually had to replay all of the final dungeon, essentially, to get to a point where I could come back and say I've completed the game, because all that extra stuff I had not done. So I had to go through this entire area, I had to fight the goblin guy again and all that. And yeah, I can't believe that I was that stupid. Anyway, this is one of the areas in which we hadn't checked out before. I didn't realise it was here. And you'll find, you can see on the map there's treasure chests in this area that we have not managed to get. So I'm going to just translate back into here. So I don't actually know what's in these chests, and I don't remember this from my original playthrough on the Wii, but what I'm going to assume is that it, is that we get a key, a small key here, which will allow us to get into that door right before you go and fight Ganon, because you needed a small key for that. I'm thinking I want to kill all the enemies first, then I want to get these guys out. But what we can do in the meantime is light. No, we can't. It's raining. That's really annoying. It's going to stop raining if we get through here. I'm a bit confused. When I came back and checked this spot out, when I was looking at how to get into after I beat Ganon, it was raining here as well when I was default. So, I haven't actually done anything in this section, I just know that it is here and I don't need to do it. Maybe that'll stop the rain. Oh yeah, everyone. No? Well, I'm confused. Oh, look. What did that do? And that's going to stop the rain. Okay. That's interesting. I knew something would eventually stop the rain. Fill our lantern with oil. And then in here. 100 rupees. Sorry, I really needed that coffee to wake me up. Anyway, after we get all the pro souls and... Oh, it's raining. After we get all the pro souls, I will be doing the Amiibo dungeon. So, look out for that, guys. Alright, we go and get this. There we go. And then we need to swap in the Dominion. So I'm assuming these go over this way. I'm just assuming, but it appears as though they go here. And I think that is correct. Looks like you can climb up the circle. I'm hoping we get something good for this. I hope we get like a heart piece and a soul piece. That'll be a heart piece. So there are a few things that I still have to check out in regard to getting different things in the game, which I will have to work out, because I'm actually completely lost as to what to do, because I didn't have a guide to start with, so that made that a little bit difficult. Alright, so is this mode view? Yes it is. Alright, so now we can go up to the top of... You've got everything you need out here, now get in the castle through the door. Thanks, Midna, for being so pushy. Alright, so we'll dig back through here. Alright, so let's go up to the top and we'll get that, whatever it's called. We'll get the door right before we fight Ganon. We'll see what's in there. Well, I actually don't know what's in there. I don't know if I've ever 100% completed this game. I know that one of my close friends back in school, when this game came out, actually had like a copy of the guide and had a pro map. So everywhere that there was a pro, it would mark it on a map. So I think he had a guide. Now I remember I photocopied that guide, or that page, so that I could find them all. And I don't think I ever found them all, just because of how frustrating it was to find some of them. Like, with the timing and all that, and I just got a bit over the game at that point, because I was playing it just to get the souls. And, yeah, it was one of those things where it was a little bit awkward because of that, but... It didn't put me off the game as such, it became about just this one thing, which I didn't want it to be. I wanted it to be about questing, and like the whole thing is that it's, you know, you're going to fight Ganon and you fight all the bosses, and I'd done that, and it was like 20 hours of extra gameplay, which I just wasn't in the mood for, or something like that. I don't know, that's just the only way I can think to explain it. Alright, so we're gonna get up here. I'm really curious as to what's in this room now. If it is just a bunch of rupees, then that's gonna be a bit sad. My hair looks so funny at the back here. Yes, I've memorized that pattern now. Oh, I need to do this. It's trying to skip one.
Yeah.
This is really gonna miss it though, but current time of the whole organ. I love that part of the game. Just hearing that sound get louder and louder. And it was so eerie as well. Chests in here by the look of it. This is like the Hyrule treasure room. Oh, you know what this means, guys. Nothing. I feel like this is just gonna be. Oh, okay, cool. You fairy. Whole lot of rupees. And I guess. Okay, I guess this essentially re-equips you for fighting Ganon if you are lucky enough to get the key to get up here. One thing I never got is like the third bomb option. I don't know if I need that for anything. Okay, so we totally went through and we're supposed to go all the way up here to, and then you go to these ones. 50, next one's gonna be 100 rupees. Mine's gonna be bombs. Happy Zelda stamp. Yeah. 100 rupees. Okay, so we got a stamp. That's not too bad, I guess. Okay, can't blow those out. Alright, now there's nothing else up here, so. I'm kind of wondering what this is. What good are you? Let's quickly save the game before I forget to show it again. We still need to get 3 pieces of heart. That's another thing I'm gonna have to look up.
Whoa, can't type Twilight Princess HD.
So this does actually, this does tell you where you can get the heart pieces. So I'm just gonna have to read through this and I guess work it out. from that. So what do we got? In Faro Woods, there's a cave in the Northwest where you initially find a small key to let your progress if you fall. If you fail to get your first time through, you have to use the lantern to get through the fog and make your way to the cave. Inside, light the two torches to make a glass chest of quite well. We've done that one. In the room with the bonglins and Deku legs, one of the Deku legs is blocking an entrance with a large chest. To defeat it, you can climb up to the platform above it, smack a nearby bonglin, and drop it over the edge so it follows it. Alternatively, you can return later when you have bombs. To complete the forest temple without getting this, you'll need the claw shot to return to this room. Alright, I guess I'm just gonna have to go through and check some of them as we make it through the game. Forest Temple, Tile Worms, I remember doing that one. And the tree, the rocks. I get 20 goats in under 3 minutes. I think we did that one, guys. Garen Mind. In the room where you walk around on the ceiling, due to the large magnetic field, you can walk to the far north corner and find a hidden platform with a large chest. I think we did that one. Divided into two areas, on the north side of the room there are two beam rays in the center, while along the east wall there is a magnetic field. Walk up to it with iron grids and turn south to find a platform with a large chest. Alright. What else have we got? Kakarika Village, done that one. Once you buy bombs and blast up, you can combine them with the hero's bow, get bomb arrows, blast the boulders to reveal a piece of heart, and use the Gale Boomerang to bring it down. Where's this one? Boulders just above Elden Spring. Alright, let's do this one. I don't remember doing this. To your immediate left, you'll come to some boulders of the rocky area, blow them up. On the third floor. Some bombs and more boulders. Use bombs to blow up the boulders on the ledge. What I'm feeling is using these, bombs, what am I doing? Did we do that then? I guess we did. I'm trying to look at the picture and work it out. Elden Spring. Yes, we've done that. Okay. Let's just... What did that do? That would be good to know. I wonder what I just knocked off that. I feel like it's just gonna be a repeat. Oh, look at that, 200 rupees. And now I've got that chest that was up there. Alright, so what's next? Like Hylia. If you do the flying thing, fishing hole, centipillars, see a piece of heart atop the rock formation. Right, you can use a fishing pole to bring it here over. You could use a Gale Boomerang to lock onto it. Sure, I've done that one. I've done the repeats of the guy. Lakebed Temple. In the middle of the ceiling, a large central chamber with the spinning staircase is a giant chandelier. You can get up there by using various targets in all the constructions. On top, you'll find a large chest for a prize. Did we do that one, guys? I feel like we didn't, but I'm not 100% sure. We could go check. Oh, I also wanted to check down here. I can't remember if we got the one that's down this way. Oh, Well, I feel like we would have done the ones that are in temples, though. Well, Skull Kid, for the first time, there is a large boulder here that you can dig down into the cavern filled with lava serpents. Defeat them all using gathering and hanging from the ceiling to make a large chest appear. Okay, I feel like we didn't do that. So, I'm just going to check this area, then we'll go to Sacred Grove. Return to the Sacred Grove and get the warp portal. Okay. Alright. Let's try that one, I think. Because I don't recall blowing things off the roof with the Gale Boomerang. And so I want to get all the pieces of heart, and then I want to get all the pirates. I can't remember if I got this one or not. I feel like I did, but also I feel like I could easily miss it. Yeah, I did get it. Alright, let's jump in here. Just for funsies. I left all that, you'll find some point. Use the flush up to get across and follow it to the room in the back plaza. Inside the light, the two torches in the room to make a large chest appear. What? After you've acquired the claw shot, you can enter the Nehru Spring and the pilot. Oh, we've done that. That's, over that way. Done that. Okay. Let's go do the Sacred Grove. Check this out. I feel like we just missed this one. I feel like I almost did it and I just complained that we didn't finish it. So I've done that. We've done that one there as well, which is get the 10,000 points. Man, this is frustrating. So I think it's in this direction. That's not what we're gonna do. I think it's saying we dig down there, which we have gone into before. But I think the thing is we can kill all the enemies. Oh, we did. Okay. Well, that's confused me. Looks like we didn't actually get a chest here. Let me just check that picture again. Where is it? Yeah, it's just here. Okay, yeah, that was that one. Death Mountain. Once you've completed the Goron Mines, there will be Gorons along the trail leading to Death Mountain. These friendly dudes will allow you to get on their back and shoot you up. The legends make a quick speak to the second Goron you come to. Get his back face with the right. Hold forward on the analog stick and you'll be able to grab on the ledge to pull yourself up. Let's go from back right here. And I'll get the bombs as well. I know I've done that other bit down the next one, which is Kakariko Gorge. Man, this is so confusing trying to work out where you've missed something as simple as a piece of heart. Alright, so alright, there we go, we've done that. Let's go get the other bomb. Did you know the Zoro boy is actually the prince of the Zoro tribe? Yeah. Got to know him better, maybe I could have gone and met the royal family and been a princess or something. Alright, so got a really big fish getaway. What? Literally. This is how they return to good health. Turn of her memory is the fruit of their efforts. As for me, nothing could bring me greater joy than to aid the daughter of an old friend. I look upon her and see her father smile. Alright, so let's go get those bombs. I'm still lost as to where I can get the pose. Let's just release that. We've got plenty of rupees. Oh, is that all we can carry? Damn. Alright, so we've got full bombs. I don't even know if we're gonna need the bug bombs for it. Bug bombs for anything on it. I think we got all the pros that are in Kakariko Village. I really need to sneeze. Sorry, guys. Ooh, that really hurt my shoulder. Oh, I went to the chiropractor yesterday before I sat down to record an episode. And I always find, I feel really good the day of the chiropractor. Like, everything's loosened up. The next day I'm all tired, and then after that I start to feel really good again. And yeah, it's just... It hurts. Just sometimes it hurts. Yeah. Alright, now. This is another one I have no idea if I've gotten it or not. Yes, I'm gonna go up. Get on their back, when it's from Kakariko, speak to the second Goron you come to, get on his back, face off to the right, right, step, hold forward, and then stick, and you'll be able to grab onto the ledge and pull yourself up. Follow the higher path to the north. Thank you. that up. There's no way to get in there, so that's just blocking the car. I guess that is the spot though. So then I'll curve off to the right, which is definitely that. But at the same time, that's the spot that looks like it's showing. But that does not look so confused. But I thought that was just creepy. Like it's showing me in the picture, but that's not what. I'm so confused. Oh. That's not what I'm supposed to do. Nice. Enter and drop down to find a last chest in front of the car. Oh, well, I guess that's up then. What else have we got? Bridge of Elden. That's not the Bridge of Elden. I'll just pop the rest of the cover. Alright, let's have to turn the other stuff. Yeah, so that's the magnetic field area. Look, Zora Man. Use it what I'm supposed to do. But that needs to be pushed to the right. What is it? I'm still trying to work that out after so long. This is just a hot spring thing. Yes. I feel like I'm just missing the complete obvious. This is my stupidity stuck in the air. Yeah, so it's just this one, isn't it? And then here. Oh, because that's like the same thing, gonna move it to the right. I'm gonna check that out.
Twilight Princess.
What's this area called?
Death Mountain Rocks near Hot Spring.
A Death Mountain where the Hot Spring is a rock. The symbol on it. How do I get rid of the rock? Need to go to the room where the entrance to the Goron Mine's dungeon is. The assuming area is located. Close to the entrance to the room is elevator. Press the switch by equipping the iron boots. Okay, let's go do that. Also, I think I just need to go through here at night time as well. There are the rooms. Let's just keep going. Let's get the iron boots out as well. Yeah, once the other stuff goes Let's push it aside. See a shortcut to the top dead end. Well, we are trying to talk to you. Sure. Yeah, so essentially it creates a shortcut. But being that we are going to try and 100% complete the game, we might as well get the shortcut. And because we needed it to be night time, because there are three parties that I have no idea where they are. At this rate, ooh, that's cool, there's a... anything up there. At this rate I feel like my laptop's gonna go flat before I even get to complete anything. Alright, so in here, and then we can drop it down. Supposedly. Yeah, so here we go. I just wanted to do it because I've been struggling to work out how to. Because there are supposedly three in this area. It's gonna get it on the left side. Okay, so the one supposedly up here. Don't know if I've got him or not. Nor do I know if there are any, dungeon. I haven't checked. I don't think there's any in like the beginning dungeon. Okay, yeah, so we haven't got the play. It is well. Okay, I believe. So it's this whole map. Yeah, there it is. Alright. Hey, Mr. Garn, turn to throw me up. Just a long episode, guys. Oh, Alright, so I think we push this to get a poke. Yeah, okay, so that's that. There's still one in this. Oh, this is this entire area. Okay. What other areas are there around here? Outside Castle Town. We can head off and do that. Two areas I've got to check. Down, yeah. Ah, see, there's one up there, and that's the last one for, like, this area then. That's cool, okay. We are making progress, guys. At least on something. Leaves us with 5 more left to get. That's pretty good, guys. Alright, so let's go down here, because we haven't done this. I don't know what's down there. I don't believe we've done this. Yeah, there's a chest there. This, might well be a piece of art. Okay, that's a piece of heart. Cool. So there's 2 more pieces of heart left. I just gotta work out where they are. Alright, so... I do want to check. There was the chest under the bridge that we saw in the ending credits cutscenes there. This way. Let us call a trainer for the sake of being lazy. Exciting. Thought it was much better than that. Alright, next. So we've got the blue in here. Sorry, down the bottom. And there's three pros there and one pro back here. Alright, so one thing I'm gonna check is the Castle Town entrance. There's supposedly one there, which I don't think we've gotten. I'm gonna work out the rest of these hearts. Garm at the bridge leading to the castle of the portion of Hyrule Field just north of there and chosen him with hot spring water. Okay. So we've done that. I've never had that happen before. We've got a pretty flower. I know we've done that one. This is for short. Arctic ground. My central room where the blue flames are stolen by the pose. There's a chest either side of the stairs. Yes, we did that. Oh, he's the one I'm picking. In the room with the massive amount of spinner rails. In the middle of it. North of the Great Bridge of Highland. I think we've done that one. No, I don't think we've done that one. Get the cannon at the top with this target against the wall in the corner. Yeah, it looked uneven, meaning you can use bombs to blow it up. Generally, you can use a bomb and change it. Break it, fall down the mysterious room. We've done that one, which was off camera. Where am I going? North of the Bridge of Hylia, which is this. Between the Great Bridge of Hylia and the area north of Castletown, there's a back route that's blocked off by boulders. After you've blown them up, it access to a shortcut which has rails all on the bottom. This way. Yeah, I'm trying to remember if I've done this or not. Piece of heart number 31. Alright, let's check this out. Don't have a heart range. I feel like we've gotten this one though. Thank you. This one's just all about timing. Piece of heart we're left in today. Let's have a look. That's the end of the instrument, which we're in the second field. Use the boomerang chain. Done that. Done the race. Done that one. Temple of Time. In the room, several little foes, dino foes, and the walls move back and forth. There's a chest in the corner, but you're unable to get it. Do you do an electric barrier? We've done that one. In the room with the spinning mechanism, raise and lower and a small structure, take it to the mid-level. Collect the small statue as well. Take them both to the south and place them on the four switches. We'll use a giant statue when you're on your way back to the entrance. This allows you to gain access to the vast south and kill the enemies in there. Then use the Dominion Rod to move the little statue. Yeah, I've done that. Temple of Time. Entrance. Temple of Time before entering the dungeon itself. There's an air statue at either side of the exit. To one side, it will reveal the area underneath the stairs with a large chest is waiting for you. Done that. Hidden Village. So we've done that. Play the game. Bridge of Elden. Warden Woods. Done that one. City in the Sky. And a large cylinder-shaped room. Big lava at the bottom, there's a chest you can see on your map on the second floor. Get to the level of the room, then work your way across the skinny platforms with the lava serpents. Once you get to the far east side, you'll see the chest directly ahead on your map. Shoot the two keys that are hanging from the ceiling of the alcove. I've done that one. Done the one floating one. Kakariko Gorge. We just did that one beforehand. Palace of Twilight. I've got that one there. I believe. The first room of the East Ring dungeon. Large chest. Alright, so one of these we missed. I know I've done that. Warden Woods. I believe I've done that one. And that. Temple of Time. Fifth floor. Temple of Time. Fifth floor. North of Castle Town. Snow Peak. Just did that one. The only one I can think of that I haven't got is the Arbiter's Grounds. Which is really annoying. Alright, let's have a look at the pose as well. Oh, the only thing is we have to wait till night. Let's go mirror chamber and watch that way down. Stuck trying to think of what we can do. As you emerge into this area, go directly north to this bridge, find a bunch of trees and you know. In the middle of all the traces, a chunk of grass that's suspiciously transformed deep down into the underground, and it has tons of dicky hoppers along with two coves. We'll come back and check that one out, but I believe I've done it. Okay, yeah, this is the part of the game where we just struggle, pretty much. And don't go down the road, because that would be a stupid idea. Apparently we can't do that. There's no doors down the bottom, is there? No. No. Well, that sucks. We literally have to... You literally have to walk to the mirror chamber every time you want to get there. That's weird. I just feel it's the only place where we could have missed a heartbeat. Just north of here. What's that one? Plus, on higher field, just must be creating behind the legend. I've done that. I read that one before. I know I've done that one, and I know I've done that one. Definitely. We just tried that one before. Like, Hylia. I feel like it's either the Lightbear Temple or the Arbiter's Grounds that we've got left. Like, that's all I can think. Kakariko Village, we've done. Done that, I believe. Very good appearance, I'm sure. Just aim carefully at the corner of the building cell. I want to give you a piece of heart in the reward. Yes. Garen Lions. Goat. Kakariko Gorge. Done that one. North of Farron. Right, the branches, forest temple. Yeah, like literally all I can think is either this temple or... Yeah, like I have no idea anymore. Looking for pros. Okay. We still have to find that heart piece. Oh, guys, there's a so we need it to be not what I will do. Because that's all the pose from this section of the map then. I think that's fine, because we need to be nighttime to get the pose, of course. So. Alright, let's look at this heart piece. Whoa. Let's find where it is. Arbiter's grounds. There. So I know we've done the first floor one, so it's basement, in the room with the massive spinnerets. Up and left, and then down, down, and all the way to the right there, and check there. One second. In the middle of the room, the massive mountain rails. In the mid-level, you can get to has a rotating spike log thing of death. To the far west side, where there's a chest in the upper platform. What am I doing? I can just check the map because I've got the compass. And there are no chests in here. So we're wasting our time if I go. I am stupid. That's literally what I have to do to check if we're missing it from within, like a temple dungeon. Does time pass within? Dungeons in this one. There's something I need to do. But now we're going out, we literally just have to wait till it's night time. So we can get that Po, and then I know we've got this area complete. How long is it going to take, guys? Or will it actually become day and night while we're in this area? Let's go out into the main area, because I feel like that's generally hard. Time of Azura's domain. Where's the desert? No. 19. Return to the bend down the middle of the building, waiting 14 gold then at 9. Alright. Pretty easy. Let's go wait for the time to come now. What can we do when we wait for time to pass? I can get some more rookies. I know, let's talk about something. So, for my course at the moment, I'm actually filming a 5-minute factual documentary segments, which is really cool. I'm looking at going to Oz Comic Con with some of my mates to do a section there. It should be absolutely awesome if we get that, so hopefully we do. And if we do, do get that, I'll let you know if it goes to the air as well. If not, I'll talk to the guys about seeing how we can share it with them. If we're allowed to or whatever. I don't know how that works. Passing time, oh man, it's gonna take forever. Good guy. Thank you, man. Alright, how long do we have to wait? What else can we, let's look up what other pros we can get. Castle Town, we did that one. Done the Kakariko. There is either one still in like the Sacred Grove area that we need to get. Or there is one. Trying to think. The one still down near the not Sacred Grove, the area before that, where there's now the purple block. That area, there could be one there. Just trying to look it up. Zora's Domain, Temple of Time. I believe we've done the Temple of Time Bridge. Yeah, because literally we're gonna just have to go to each area and check with the lantern, I think. In this map. So let's have a look. 41 to 43, just south of the Heaven Stone, is a boulder block in the lake. Cavern, blow it up and traverse. Cavern to find the pros along the way. I think we got all the pros in that area. That's up here. second tier of riches. Yes, we've done that. We've done that. Is that anything on this pre-generated map area? It should be showing. And yeah, that's that. Okay. So one thing I will do is go down to the lakebed temple, which will mean we need this beauty on, and see if we miss a piece of heart down there. Okay. We're swimming now. Well, that is kind of obvious that we're swimming. Yeah, because I don't actually know where else we could go. Let me check this.
Bottom of water. Of Lake Hylia. Twilight Princess. What comes up?
Is that where you swim out with Zora friend? Oh, I think that's what it is when you go down. Okay. I think that's all that is. I'm just being stupid thinking it's something special. When you in Kakarika Village you can go through like a little warp hole, I guess, and brings you back down to this area. And you're with Zora. Alright. GoPro is running out of battery. It's 12 o'clock midday. Now don't know what to do anymore. Woohoo. Woohoo. Let's drop right down really quickly. So once we're in here, we can check our map and see if we've still got like a chest to get. Oh, there's a chest there, basement floor 1. Lake Bed Temple. Give me floors. Oh, we've actually got quite a few chests here that we have to get. So we've got one on the fourth floor. Not in the middle, basement floor. Not 100% sure, but there are some chests that we didn't get, so let's attempt to get them now. This is the only thing that sucks about trying to do a game 100% when you don't have the guide to begin with. Because if you're following the guide, you know exactly what you need to do in each section. Now I believe we have the chest in the middle. It's not showing up on the map. Me, don't know why I'm still kind of contemplating the fact that we didn't get it. So this would be the bit that we haven't got. especially because we didn't know what they sound. Have all the heart pieces now. Awesome! Alright, so I close that tab down. And now we can just try and pick out the Clover. Alright, we're actually doing really well. I don't know if I've got all this. Is there a way to check the stamps? Yes, how many stamps are there? Oh wow, there are a heap of stamps that we don't have.